Following that advice from the congressman, our next speaker is Professor Vladimir Pavlenko. He's the Vice President of the International Arctic Science Consortium, IASC, and Director of the Federal Arctic Research Center of Russian Academy of Sciences in Arkhangelsk, Russia. And he's going to speak to us on Arctic research in Russia. Professor?
First of all, I would like to thank U.S. Arctic Research Commission for invitation to participate in this symposium. It is a great honor for me. The beginning of Arctic research in Russia by the 14th century and was connected exclusively with the prospects of exploring of new territories and resources. In this connection, it was necessary to shape the direction, investigations, and infrastructure. The first explorers in our country is rightly recognized as a Pamir people, who lived on the territory of the modern Arkhangelsk region. Main government organizations which respond for Arctic research in Russia, is Russian Academy of Sciences, Federal Service on Hydrometeorology and Environmental Monitoring, Ministry of Education and Science, Ministry of Healthcare, Ministry of Natural Resources and Environment, Federal Services of Fisheries. Each of these agencies has its own network of research organizations focused on the Arctic. However, the largest number of scientific organizations, excuse me. I would not repeat my report. Thank you. It's okay. I put it in the computer. however, the largest number of scientific organizations and specialists connected with years of study fundamental and applied problems of the Arctic are concentrated in the Russian Academy of Sciences. And validity of this approach is determined by the nature of the solution of specific research and development tasks. This was especially evident after the unifications of Russian Academy of Sciences, Russian Academy of Medical of Science, and Russian Academy of Agriculture of Science. The richest the research tasks combined and solved in particular for the Arctic has risen sparsely increased. each of other government agencies has its own scientific programs of Arctic research. For example, Ross Hydromet solve in particular the problems of modernization of the network of observing stations in the Arctic coastal zone. Ministry of Natural Resources, Mineral Exploration, Ministry of Health expanding the network of modern hospitals on the base of the research organizations of the Russian Academy of Sciences in Arctic, Federal Agency for Fisheries search and estimate of resources for industry, Ministry of Science and Education Russia, formation of a research base in the Arctic universities, Ministry of Defense of the Russian Federation realized the tasks similar for those that we discussed yesterday, Chief of Naval Research, Admiral David Hahn. the joint efforts of the scientific organization of all agencies is a rule in the framework of the state research programs and projects. This includes, for example, can be attribute of the federal scientific programs like World Ocean, Materials, and Technology for the North, and others. Main regional clusters, Russian Academy of Sciences, of the Arctic Research in Russia is located in a different part of our country. You can see in a map and title of this scientific center. For example, Kola Scientific Center is located in the Murmansk region. Karelian Scientific Center located in the Karelia Republic. Federal Scientific Center in Arkhangelsk, region, of course, this is European part for our country. Komi Scientific Center is located in the Komi Republic. Tumen Scientific Center is located in West Siberia. Krasnoyarsk Scientific Center is located in East Siberia. Yakutsk Scientific Center located in the Republic Sakha of Yakutia and East Siberia as well. And Northwest, oops, excuse me, Northeastern Scientific Center located in Magadan, it's as far east our country, and Kamchatka Scientific Center is far east in far eastern part of Russia as well, in Petropavlovsk-Kamchatsky. You can see that the center like around the Arctic. The regional scientific clusters of Russian Academy of Sciences in the Arctic research include more than 7,000 scientists and 43 research institutes, 21 standing central departments of basic and applied research, laboratories and tests, sites, doctorate courses in over 40 disciplines, scientific journals and publication facilities, scientific archives and museums, United Information System and e-libraries, social infrastructure and number scientific station, advanced network of international cooperation. Nikolai Lavrov Federal Center for Integrated Arctic Research, Russian Academy of Sciences, is a new scientific organization, was established in April 2016 by special decision of Russian government. Objective foundation of the center to establish on the territory of the Arctic zone of the Russian Federation, a research institution specialized in integrated specific support of balanced social economic development and improvement of life quality of population of the region of the Russian zone, of the Arctic zone Russian Federation. Today, Federal Scientific Center for Integrated Arctic Research includes 7 institutes and 2 separate scientific stations, which is located in Arctic zone. Main function, our center, to be integrated Arctic research in Russia. direction, fundamental and applied research, Federal Scientific Center, include problems of Northern Sea Route and coastal zone Russian Federation in Arctic, ecological impacts, climate change and biodiversity, balance between infrastructure and social development, biomedical issues including indigenous people, ethno-social and cultural process, international cooperation in the Arctic and others. In one presentation, impossible to introduce scientific programs each from 43 institutes, and I combined them into groups of field of science. For example, problems of Arctic geology, geochemistry, geophysics, mineralogy, mining, petrology, geology, oil and gas deposits, health, physiology, processing of mineral raw materials is include in the scientific programs, 7 scientific centers in Russia. Problems hydrology and hydrophysics of the Arctic and subarctic water system, marine science, include in the scientific programs, 5th scientific center. Excuse me, I read not. Problems of ecology, ecosystem, and bioresources of the Arctic and subarctic regions and seas, industrial ecology, northern and Arctic forestry and agriculture, including scientific program on 7 center in Russian Academy of Sciences. Main areas of economy, infrastructure, industrial development in the Arctic and northern region include in program 6 scientific centers. Social and humanitarian issues of the northern development, human health in the Arctic include in the program, scientific program, and 7 scientific center, our Academy of Sciences. Financial and logistical support to the Arctic research at the Russian Academy of Sciences provide not only state budget, and the Russian Foundation for Basic Research, Russian Scientific Foundation, and other sources, Russian and international foundation, private funds, commercialization of intellectual property. In this connection, I would like to emphasize a program of basic research of Presidium of Russian Academy of Sciences, which call basic scientific research for benefit of development of the Arctic zone of the Russian Federation. Participate on competitive basis around 100 institutes, including located in the Arctic zone, Russian Federation. Thank you for your attention.
I think Vladimir gets the medal for timeliness. And I was so scared all along. Fantastic. We have a few questions for you, Vladimir.
Yes, please.
Okay. The amount of research in Russia is very impressive. What obstacle to closer cooperation between the U.S. and Russian, should be Russia, on Arctic research can we overcome and how? Any obstacles between closer cooperation?
You mean some of example of our cooperation? Examples?
What obstacles are there to closer cooperation between the U.S. and Russia on Arctic research, and if any, how can we overcome them, and how? Obstacle in Russian, it means difficulty. Difficulties.
We have not difficulties with the connection with our partners from other countries, including Arctic countries as well, in Arctic research. Maybe very interesting problems with the connection with white border in Arctic ocean, which discussed before. I would like remark that about maybe 5-7 years ago, Vice President Academy of Sciences, Academician Lavrov, create small scientific group, and I was involved from Academy of Science in this group, and we discuss about ideas which will be a base for create borders, Arctic countries in the Arctic Ocean. And this model we create during 2-3 years, maybe, we're creating models about reconstruction, create modern Arctic zone, and we start from time 150 million years ago. And during the next several years, we have rather close contact with our colleagues from Arctic countries in framework different scientific conferences in different countries and discuss about methodology use this model for create borders our country in Arctic. And this is idea was is a base in our application to the Commission of United Nations.
Thank you. Any other questions?
It's just it's not so difficult. It's just our view for connection, for collaboration.
Yeah, obstacles could be opportunities. So any other questions for Professor Pavlenko? If not, thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.